back. Oh, it's a controller. Can't see it. Oh, there it is. How do I get upstairs?
Oh, I'd love to tell you.
But then I'd have to kill
people. Actually,
put a pin in it.
Yeah, yeah. I should let
Sorry.
You go.
That door leads to Emma and Gregory's room.
Stop acting like you're 15. You're a grown woman.
A keychain pendant for the greenhouse. What's that doing in Emma and Gregory's room, I wonder? And why is the key missing?
Do you like dogs? Some propane flask. Well, let me put my head through this loop down.
Now, this is interesting, 47. A letter from Emma's mother stating that Emma is the illegitimate child of Alexa's late older brother, Montgomery. And listen to this. She claims to have witnessed Alexa and Zachary murder him. The plot thickens.
That's everything in here, isn't it? Is that a phone? once again. Maybe if I... What's in there? I'm gonna go to the greenhouse. Upstairs. Here.
Excuse me, sir. You're trespassing. Please turn around, sir.
Oh shit. Okay, this is dead boys. Study.
Aaron Ford. First from the Carlisle account, HTC depot number 5085. No, I need it immediately. Yes, I'll hold. Yes, I'm still here. It doesn't exist. What do you mean it doesn't exist? I'll double check and get back to you.
Use this.
Did the portrait photographer check out? Verified his identity.
Everything's in order.
just gonna check out the the greenhouse. Where's the greenhouse?
On top of everything, Rosie thinks she's in love with young Patrick.
Yes,
I mean, that's
sir.
A breaking heart happening if I ever saw one.
Poor thing.
And that detective asked to come here. Madame Carlyle must believe Zachary was murdered. Why else ask him to snoop around?
I feel weak in my knees from all the tension here.
Don't worry, I'm sure everything will settle down soon.
You see my locker key around?
I see a lot of keys around. You're going to have to be a bit more specific. Does it have a fun keychain on it or anything?
No. Just a
massive level, anyway.
I was just, I don't know, thinking about Zachary. He spent most of his life in here with.
Oh, okay.
If you need me, if you'd excuse me.
I don't believe for a second that Zachary committed suicide. We'd only just run through his plan for the spring seedlings yesterday.
Yeah, sure. But he was upset believing his sister was dead.
I'd say worried about how things would be handled with Gregory and Emma taking over. I said they let him stay here, but Ethel was sure Emma would throw him out first chance she got. And now we'll never know.
Oh, my. You're taking this hard, aren't you?
Emma Carlyle. Can you tell me where you were yesterday evening?
Surely I'm not a suspect.
I need to account for everyone.
Well, I spent the evening with my family, but I got an awful migraine and had to take to bed. Everyone can attest to that. I believe I went up when the boys sat down for a drink around 8 o'clock. Is that all?
How did you feel about Zachary?
I might as well be honest. His presence was always awkward. How do you have a meaningful conversation with a man who only cares about plants? In my opinion, Alexa bears some responsibility for how this ended. She supported his self-limiting behavior by letting him live here. Anything else you want to know?
We shall all miss him dearly.
Have you noticed anything else out of the ordinary?
Nothing special comes to mind. Except perhaps I did get a feeling that Zachary was depressed, not just sad. I suppose he realized that he had no one with Alexa gone. Even Alexa must feel the pangs of guilt over that one, letting him believe she was dead. Then again, guilt isn't her strong suit.
Okay, so we've questioned. Alibi confirmed, questioned. Rebecca, questioned. Alibi confirmed for Edward. Alibi confirmed for Gregory. So we're either, we're down to two, and the butler. Could it be that the butler did it? I don't know.
I will never again meet someone like Zachary. I can't bear to think what will happen to all these rare plants now.
Oh, come on, Oliver. I understand why you're so upset. It's such a shock to all of us.
Yeah, keep it real.
Don't know where the keys are.
Today is just not my day.
Pain in the arse, this always online shit for a single player game.
Of Carlisle's daughter.
Rebecca? Yes. She's insistent, that one. She kept asking all kinds of questions. Who had the other one? Why I gave it to her, that sort of thing. You did make sure she didn't see you give the other one to the butler?
Oh, of course.
Greetings, sir.
Things. Got the hair scheme. Want to see that? Check out the
Madame Carlisle wants to inspect the arrangements for the staged funeral tomorrow. What's the delay?
It's the birds. They're making a racket, droppings everywhere. The undertaker wants them gone before he'll see Madame Carlisle. He's in a right state. So unless you want to take on the birds, I suggest you stay clear of him.
Oh, no, my aim's horrible. Safer for everyone if I just wait here till he says he's ready for Madam.
Madam Carlisle is still going ahead with her staged funeral tomorrow, and she wants to inspect the arrangements. How about it, 47? You feel up to giving her the grand tour of her final resting place?
I'm sticking with the detective story at the moment, but at least I'm unlocking shit.
I die in the autumn. I love autumn funerals.
Madame Carlyle isn't dead, so there is no funeral. Not if you ask me.
Well, I still think it's going to be a beautiful service.
Well, I'm siding with the Undertaker on this one. It's wrong pretending to be dead. Some things you don't mess with. Not even if you're filthy rich.
All right, who's talking? Who the hell's he talking to?
Clear hit on those nests.
Oh, we've got a crowbar.
I need those birds gone, do you hear me?
I don't think they want to leave. They're always gathering in that tree, sir.
I don't care what they want. Christ! I have enough on my mind as it is. Scare them! Shoot them! I don't care! I just want them gone! Fake funeral. Where's my credibility if this gets out? The nerve of that woman. Jeopardizing everything I've worked for. My father worked for.
I doubt that's true, though. Though he was here when the safe in Madame Carlyle's office was repaired last week. He had to carry some heavy bolts to the top floor to complain about back pain for the entire weekend.
A safe in Madame Carlyle's office. I bet that's where she keeps the file on Arthur Edwards.
Seriously, Denton? What a knob.
What a knob. Oh, what's that? Water bolt. Is that your escape? Is that our escape route? I think it could be.
Now Zachary won't get to see the rhododendron perigillium blossom. They were his favourites.
I know, Oliver, I know. We shall all miss him dearly.
He spent most of his life here with these plants. Not much of a life, is it? Well, anyway, I'll be outside if you need me. If you'd excuse me.
See if I can get in when she opens the door.
Broken lab equipment. It looks like it was recently used, though.
So that's what was poisoned?
I will never again meet someone like Zachary. I can't bear to think what will happen to all his rare plants now.
Oh, come on, Oliver. I understand why you're so upset.
It's such a shock to all of us. It's just typical that Annie gets to help the photographer. I'm the pretty one. But work, 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 that's all I get from her.
Good. Thank you, fucking our fall down here, too.
Yes, your blown due diligence, and almost unnatural ability to focus. I remember when I was 7, and the police came to tell us that Father had died in a car accident. You took in the information and then asked us all to wait because you had an important call you'd need to take. I remember how the officers were stunned by your strength and focus, I'm sure. And I have always strived for that sort of control in difficult situations.
Okay. I haven't found a key yet, but I've got a crowbar, so I think I'm going to break into the... Is it his office down here? Oh. Room is accessible through the storage room in the staff quarters on the ground floor of the mansion. List remembers the Furby, the butler. It details various preparations for tomorrow's pretend phone and a photo shoot. The handwriting does not match Zachary Carlyle's suicide note. Does that put him in the clear? Not yet. Okay. Head upstairs. Remember where upstairs is.
Do you see this about old Wompy? You see fancy, doesn't you?
should probably...
be mine. All right,
yeah.
Later. Look at me getting all giddy. It's like year 10 all over again, just without the awkward slow dancing.
That's Madame Carlyle taken care of. Time to get the file on Arthur Edwards.
What happened there? I don't know what I did to kill her. Is that the...
How are you today, sir?
This thingy's bobs. One. Stay at this place.
I can see from the log that Rebecca was in a conference call from 9 p.m. to midnight last night.
Okay. We're down to Emma and Mr. Fernsby then. Investigate. whose room have I got to investigate now? Oh, that's a map. Emma Gregory's rooms. It's the one where the... The girl's doing the brushing in front of it.
You must have been in some incredibly dangerous situation.
I should
Maybe
get
we
back
should
to...
get back to...
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Hello there, sir.
Hello.
Didn't you say something about a shake before? Sorry, but I think
Right. Yeah, what'd you say?
Oh, 3 out of 4. Okay, there's one clue. Not on Rebecca's room. I've got clue. I only found one clue, Mr. Green. Oh, okay. One clue. I don't know what this other way the other clue is. This is upside. access to your tablet. See if I can find two other clues. I don't know where from.
About that promotion I thought might be coming my way. Yeah, well, don't count on it. This is a shit assignment. No, I didn't expect this. Yates didn't even warn me, and now he doesn't return my calls. I just wish I was home. I love you too. Bye.
Save it.
Please stop. Oh!
This all confirms that Arthur Edwards stole everything from Madame Carlyle. Perhaps you should let her know how bad it is, 47.
Come on, this is me. Yeah, looking at him right now. Don't worry, they can have a track.
I think I've been in everybody's room. I'm lost as to where those extra bits that are.
Zachary's diary. This is big. He was about to confess to the world that he and Alexa murdered their older brother Montgomery 46 years ago. And apparently, Mr. Fernsby helped make the murder look like an accident. And 47, the handwriting doesn't match the suicide letter in his room, proving he didn't write it himself.
The butler did do it.
Painkiller. Lethal, if you use enough of them.
But not the poison used to kill Zachary. Of course, Madame Carlyle doesn't know that. Are you considering to frame the butler, 47? Mr. Fernsby clearly didn't commit the murder, but I think you have enough evidence to convince Madame Carlyle he did. Maybe you should tell him you are ready to present your findings. Unless, of course, you want to do some more detecting, 47?
Who's Zachary's room? I've only one more clue out of Emma's room, and I can't find anything. I've been up there twice now.